Good day, students. In this group, we're going to be going over operations on complex numbers in polar form. We're going to be examining how to find the product, quotient, power, and roots of complex numbers in polar form. We're going to start off by taking a look at some of the formulas that we're going to be using for the process. So let's write this down, formulas. All right, so let's start with the product formula. The formulas basically apply to the following situation. And let's say for complex numbers, z1 is R1, that's the radius, times cosine theta 1 plus I sine theta 1. And another complex number Z2, which is R2 cosine theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. We have the following formula. So for product, the product expressed as z1 times z2 is given by r1 r2 cosine theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sine theta 1 plus theta 2. All right, so let's take a look at this formula for a second. What is this formula telling us to do when we're multiplying two complex numbers in polar form? The formula is telling us that we'll simply just multiply the radii and add the angles. Okay, so that's how you find the product of complex numbers in polar form. All right, let's take a look at the next formula, which is for the quotient. For the quotient, z1 over z2, please keep track of the order here, is equal to R1 over R2 times, you see in this, in the case of the product, it was times, now it's the quotient, cosine. Now can you guess what will be done with the angles here? This was a product, it became a quotient, this is a sum, it's not going to be the opposite, which is a difference. So theta 1 minus theta 2 plus I sine theta 1 minus theta 2. Okay, and then we also have a formula for the power. Power is due to repeated multiplication. So if we have z1 to the nth power, what you're going to have is the r1 multiplied by itself n number of times. Repeated multiplication can be expressed using exponents, so that will be r1 to the nth power times cosine. Now when you multiply z1 by itself n times, you're going to add theta 1 to itself n times. So repeated addition is multiplication, so you're going to have n theta 1 plus the same story with the sine angle, which is going to be n theta 1 also. And then we also have the root formula. The nth root of z1, which is equal to z1 raised to the 1 over n, using the nth root property of exponents. This can be written as r1 raised to the 1 over n, that's the nth root of r1, times cosine theta 1 over n plus I sine theta 1 over n. Okay, this is the formula for finding the principal root. The principal roots. There are other roots, but this one is just for finding the principal root. All right, with all these formulas in mind, let's go ahead and consider the first example. Example 1. For z1 equals 3 cosine pi over 3 plus I sine pi over 3. And we have another complex number in polar form Z2, which equals 5 cosine pi over 6 plus I sine pi over 6. Now with this situation, we're going to find the following. A, we're going to find Z1 times Z2. So find Z1 times Z2. We're also going to find Z2 over Z1. And then we're going to find, for the part C, we're going to look for Z1 raised to the third power. And then for the part D, we're going to find the fourth root of Z2. Okay, so these are the things we're going to find in example one. Let's start with the first one. So for part A, we're looking for Z1 times Z2. So remember the process. For products, we're to multiply the radii and add the angles. Okay, so this is R1 and this is R2. This is theta 1, this is theta 2. Let me just indicate it for you so you can see. This is R1. R1 basically means the radius of the first complex number in polar form. And then theta 1 is the radius, is the angle of the first complex number in polar form. So the same idea applies to the second complex number, R2, theta 2. All right, now we can go ahead and compute the product. This is theta 1 also. One thing you want to note about complex numbers in polar form is that these two angular arguments are always the same. All right, so Z1, Z2, we're going to have 3 times 5. That's R1 times R2 cosine theta 1 plus theta 2 is pi over 3 plus pi over 6 plus I sine pi over 3 plus pi over 6. Okay, so what's pi over 3 plus pi over 6? Let's do our scratch work over here. Pi over 3 plus pi over 6. We need to find the LCD, so multiply by 2 top and bottom. We have 2 pi over 6 plus pi over 6. That's 3 pi over 6, which reduces to pi over 2. Okay, so that's the angular value of the sum of these two angles, theta 1 plus theta 2. So our final result is going to be 3 times 5, 15. 15 cosine pi over 2 plus I sine pi over 2. Okay, so this is your answer in polar form. So let's indicate the form. You can write this in rectangular form also, but this is just the answer in polar form. Okay, let's take a look at question number, the B part. We want to find Z2 divided by Z1. Now, if we consult the quotient formula, you notice that you just basically divide the radii and find the difference between the angles. So let's go ahead and apply that here. So R2 comes first, so that goes in the numerator, and then the denominator goes in the denominator. So we have 3 there, and then we have cosine. The radius of the number in the numerator, the angle of the complex number in the numerator goes first when you're subtracting, so theta 2 will come first, pi over 6 minus pi over 3, it's theta 1, plus I sine, same argument, pi over 6 minus pi over 3. Okay, all right, so let's go ahead and do some scratch work here to find the result of this difference. So pi over 6 minus pi over 3. So we are going to find the LCD, of course, times this by 2 top and bottom. So we have pi over 6 minus 2 pi over 6. And then that gives us negative pi over 6. Now that's the argument for our angle. Okay, so our final result is going to be 5 over 3 cosine negative pi over 6 plus I sine negative pi over 6. Okay, so that's your final result of the quotient of the two numbers, z2 over z1, in polar form. All right, let's indicate the form that it's in. Remember, this can also be converted to rectangular form. You just find cosine and sine of the angles and distribute the radius across the real and imaginary parts. Part C, we are to find the power, z1 to the third power. So let's consult the formula again for guidance. So we are to raise the radius to the nth power and then multiply the angle by the power, okay? So let's go ahead and do that. So R1 is 3, so we're going to raise 3 to the third power. Cosine, the same power again, 3 times the angle. Theta 1 was pi over 3. Plus, same story with sine. Sine is going to be 3 times pi over 3. Let's go ahead and simplify that. 3 to the third power is 27. 27 cosine pi plus I sine pi. And there goes your answer in polar form.